てめえさっき違う。あなたは間違っている。干渉で曇った目には何も見えない。あなたは間違っている。 命は星を巡る。だが星が消えればそれも終わりだ。星は消えない。終わるのはお前だ。
帰ってきたってのに随分な歓迎だな。たくよ、自由の代償は高いぜ。
Some sort of flashback. She doesn't want to lose him too.
向こうには何があるの?
の姫、聞いたよね。
kaatsute kono hoshi ni ikita hito tachi no koe hoshi o meguru inochi no sakebi
sephiroth no sei nan daro
ano hito wa himei nante kini shinai nan demo nai kedo kakegae no nai hibi yorokobi ya shiyawase nante kitto kini shinai な人なくしても泣いたり叫んだりしないセフィロスが大事なのは星と自分守るためなら何でもするそんなの間違ってると思う星の本当の敵はセフィロスだから止めたいそれをクラウドにみんなに手伝ってほしかったこのみんなが一緒ならできるでもこの壁は運命の壁入ったら越えたらみんなも変わってしまうだから、ごめんね。引き止めちゃった。
迷う必要はない。セフィロスを倒そう。
Going in. Destiny's Crossroads. When you cross the barrier of whispers, strange and terrible things may be waiting on the other side. Before making the leap, make sure that your party is well rested and well stocked with equipment and materia. The vending machine back on the expressway will have everything needed. Oh, so this is the final boss. I thought we just went through most of the final stuff. I don't really need anything other than the mega potions or something. Go back to vending machines? Yeah. Oh, I can actually buy cheap stuff. Don't think I need anything else. Honestly, having 36 mega potions is more than enough. I believe, yeah, I have a lot of these already, too. I should probably check accessories. I guess we're good. 壁を越えちまうと戻ってこれねえよ。 Real question is, we can't really go anywhere anyways. We're pretty much just stuck between is our destiny to defy destiny? You can't really, there's nowhere to go.
Ready.
Kabe, usui to ii ne.
Unmei no saigo no toride da. Sou wa ikanai.
Ikuzo.
Let's do it.
こんなの何度も超えてきたぞ。壁が見えるか見えないか、それだけの違いよ。
Let us back in the way we came. So where are we gonna run to? No way to run. Looking at. So we're technically inside the rift. Happening, I think. So we're in a perpetual battle sequence.
Of course.
Arbiter of Fate. Whoa. It's like one of each element. That one like just hates me. Oh, correction. Again? Oh, they healed all together. My timing's so off. That's a projectile. Intercession. Round 3. What if this is all timed or something? They're fighting one of them.
Look
Wow, not enough. Oh, he stops me. I don't mind just limit breaking right now. It's over. That thing's staggered. Oh. Whatever damage I do to it probably does it to the main enemy. It's one of us. What? Is the future? This is the end of the original. Maybe I don't want to fight them when they have, switch over to cliffhanger probably. Had Claudia over here. Ultra big boy is mine. Heal me. Uh-oh. Super boss? Whoa. Is that Bahamut? Looks like a Bahamut. Yep, it's for a Bahamut. Oh, it's unblockable. Bad. Oh, what? Grab. Oh, he's full life. Never mind. That's I don't think you can dodge those. Ooh. Defeated. Oh, back to three. Actually, let's try a limit break. Stardust ray too. One down. Two more, right? Yep. I should have killed the red one. mission. Oh, it's done.
ここは早く来い、クラウド。
Wrong buttons.
Counterattack.
What? The block didn't work. Dang it.
Okay.
Gravity squeeze. Stand off. I had to counter like the last one. Oh shit. Oh, what? Dodge. It's really hard to see, like... It's hard to see, like, which, direction the Hell's Gate's going in.
Hmm. One winged angel. Gravity.
Eris would be the one that has What, I blocked? Oh, okay. Blocking works. Oh. happening. Oh, next phase. Shadow players are messed up because they suck you in. Nine. Pretty sure he's counting down to that meteor hit. Teleported, that best. Holy crap. Yeah, it's over. Meteor dispelled.
我々の星はあれの一部になるらしい。俺は消えたくない。お前を消したくはない。ここは？ 世界の先端だ。お前の力が必要だ、クラウド。 運命に抗ってみないか。週末の7秒前だが、まだ間に合う。未来はお前次第だ、クラウド。
副社長、
社長、
わかった。クラウド、見た。
Darling.
Hi. Tōchan. どっちへ行けばいいんだろう。
でも倒しただろう。
追いかけよ。大丈夫。私も行く。
追跡ならば花が必要だろう。
あいつは星を壊すつもりなんだろう。星の敵はアバランチの敵だ。
空、嫌いだな。I would be lost, drifting alone, floating up high, time after time, and there you'd be, shining bright.Smiling face to guide my way. Bloody and
that is the end of part one of VII Remake. Definitely a lot to take in. Lots of changes, of course. Though I think the main like flow of the story is still the same. And again, it's interesting that we...fought pretty much the Whispers, which is like the planet's way of sealing everyone's fate. Because now that I think about it, throughout the whole game, every time I guess something different is supposed to happen, the Whispers show up to stop a change from happening, as we saw with Wedge surviving. Originally he was supposed to die, Biggs. Same thing. He was supposed to die too, but as we see, he survived. No sign of Jesse yet. I don't know what they plan to do, if they even plan to bring her back. I'm not sure how she could survive. I mean, we weren't sure how Biggs was going to survive, but he survived. And then just the whole segment with Zack, I guess, fighting against his own fate, because he could have definitely just died while fighting all those Shinra soldiers at the end there. But even then, I think he did survive, because he was able to take Cloud back to Midgar. I think it's just, I'm trying to remember exactly when Zack does die in the original timeline. So again, I don't know exactly what their plan is. Oh, we also didn't fight Roush again. So there's just so much stuff that they've introduced into this first part. Because again, there's still that main group of Avalanche, the ones that saved us back when we infiltrated Shinra Warehouse. They saved us there, more or less. But we never saw them again. Even with the infiltration of Shinra headquarters, they didn't show up again. They did do some bombings and stuff, I guess, just to catch them off guard, but we didn't see any fighting. None of those soldiers came in to fight, so we didn't see them again, pretty much, after that first time. But yeah, I definitely feel for Eris, because I don't know. I guess them crossing paths, because he like went back to Midgar and she's like leaving Midgar. I guess just symbolic crossing of paths. And again, she's more, what was it? She can sense spirits a lot easier than most of us, or than most other people. She can really hear the planet, you know, because that was just her ancient bloodline, or the Cetra bloodline. So she was able to sense Zack, and maybe that was the last time he was alive, and she was able to cross that path. But let me see, maybe there's a post-game screen. Not quite yet. Yeah, I guess I'll just let the credits roll. But yeah, I don't even know how to process all of this. I'm going to definitely have to play this over again just to get more of the details. But definitely beautiful game. Definitely worth the wait. I mean, all this is pretty much perfect. I mean, I can't say anything bad about this game. Everything was necessary. If you want to say anything bad, I guess it's the how linear it was up until, say, chapter 14, I believe. That was the last time you got to be in the slums area. After that, it kind of just snowballed to the ending. But I wonder if in part two we actually get to go back to Midgar if we wanted to do like open world stuff. But yeah, definitely for those diehard fans of Final Fantasy VII, this is like definitely like a dream come true for them to remake it and just have more lore, you know, more character development. Everything. And again, it was really nice to see the subtle changes and additions they made to the game. Just seeing It's more about the characters. I don't know. It just feels fulfilling, you know? But I also feel like the idea of, again, we pretty much, I guess, killed the Whispers, I guess. I feel like they're infinite, though, right? Because if they're the planet's kind of will to follow a certain trajectory, then I feel like they should always kind of be an enemy of sorts or antagonist. Because how else are we supposed to defeat them if they are the whole planet? So, I'm not sure. I'm not sure what they're going to do next. I'm pretty sure they already have like a storyboard all kind of planned out, but again, it's just crazy how much stuff they've done just in this game by itself. And to imagine it's going to be like two, maybe three parts to this, it'd be crazy. But, man, we just started playing this 2 weeks ago, and feel nostalgic already just looking through all the action scenes that has happened. And it's crazy because pretty much the whole game was like cutscenes almost. The battle transitions were very smooth. But yeah, no complaints here. Yeah, next stop, hard mode. Till then, I'm just gonna let the credits roll and so we can all enjoy.